Hello students, in this lecture we are going to study second example of oxidation in our everyday life, that is rancidity. Student, you must have seen when you eat OS, when you eat kurkuras, when you eat chips, they are very much filled with air. Do you know that why they are filled with air, or some other gas was filled in it? Can you tell? And whether you have to purchase a packet filled with air or the packet which did not have air, which was in a compressed form. Can you tell? The compressed form packet is not good for you. Do you know that oxygen has entered in that and it has oxidized the fatty food inside it? The same phenomena which we are going to read today, that is rancidity. Oxidation of fatty and oily food. You know that your kurkuras, chips, all they are fatty foods. And when they mix with oxygen, means the process of oxidation starts, and which give bad smell to that eating food material. So, whenever you are going to shop, always purchase the packet which is filled with air, means which is airtight, and which need not have oxygen inside it, which will not give rise to bad smell, isn't it? Now we have some methods of to stop rancidity. The first method is airtight container. You must have seen your mama keep all the pulses, all the this food eatable material inside a airtight container. Can you tell why she keep them in airtight container? So that the oxygen will not enter in that, and it will not spoil the food. The next, by using anti-oxidizing agents. What are anti? Anti means opposite of oxygen, which need not, which stop the supply of oxygen. They are called antioxidants, substance which prevent oxidation. For example, we have BHA, means butylated hydroxyl anisole, and BHC, butylated hydroxyl toluene. We can use BHA, no need to learn them, as you can use short forms also, BHA and BHT, as an antioxidant to prevent our food material from rancidity. Now next is flushing out with nitrogen. Student, you should know that whenever these packets are packed, first they are flushed out with nitrogen gas, so that the nitrogen was inactive in nature. It will prevent the supply of oxygen inside the packet, and then it is vacuum packed. Okay, so before packaging, we always flush out the packets with nitrogen gas to avoid oxidation. Then refrigerator. When you have eaten food and it is still left, then what your mama did? Your mama keep it inside the refrigerator. A refrigerator provide low temperature so that the microbes will not act in it and it will not spoil the food. This is the way how we can take the food for a longer time, isn't it? Then comes oiling and pickling. You must have seen your grandmothers making pickles for you, isn't it? And sometimes we use vinegar also to have our food preserved for a long period of time. When you went to hotels, you must have eaten the onion with vinegar, that reddish one, which are very much tasty to eat also. How they are can be prevented for a long period of time? What the vinegar is doing there? The vinegar preserves the food to be damaged. Isn't it? So by oiling, by adding oil to it, by adding salt and sugar to any food material, it can bring it to a long period of time. Then the last method of rancidity is pasteurization. What is pasteurization? You must have seen the milk packets. If you keep your milk in kitchen for a long period of time, after 1 or 2 days, it will get spoiled. But when we use the packed food packets of that milk, they can be used for 3 to 4 days. What was the funda behind that? The funda behind that we heat the milk for at a very high temperature, and at the instant we at the once we come to it a lower temperature, and it we will not allow the microbes to enter through it. By this we can preserve our food material for a longer period of time. I think the phenomena rancidity, and in previous we have done the phenomena of corrosion, the everyday where we see the phenomena of oxidation, is clear to you. Thank you.